like a good spot.
With Fine Living Lancaster magazine. We're here for our series of Coffee in the Park. We're having some iced coffee today in Buchanan Park in front of the Rose Garden. And this is Danelle Schweitzer with Brent L. Miller on Manheim Pike. Tell us a little bit about Brent L. Miller.
So Brent L. Miller is a family-owned jewelry store, and we just love our customers, and we invite them to come in and experience the best jewelry store there is.
So what do you do at Brent L. Miller?
So I'm the engagement manager at Brent L. Miller, and what I do is help couples find their dream ring and also make sure that we have a beautiful selection for them to choose from.
So do you help purchase for the store and like choose what rings you purchase?
I do.
Ooh, that sounds fun.
It's very exciting to find all the different styles and the different trends. Right now the halo is very popular. We're starting to lean a little bit more towards the solitaires and some thin bands with diamonds. So very exciting to find the rings that the girls really love.
So do you ever have couples come in with like maybe the groom's grandmother's ring and then you take the diamond out? Do you do any like resettings?
We do a lot of that. So we take family heirlooms and we make them into a ring that someone can cherish for the rest of their life, whether it's setting it into an existing setting or custom making a setting to fit that diamond. We have 5 master goldsmiths and we can do all of that work in our store.
Oh wow, so you do it at the store?
We do.
Wow, that's very impressive. Can you tell me maybe the most exciting piece of jewelry that you've helped a couple choose?
Do you know, I find favorites all the time, so I think it's kind of currently whatever I'm working on. Engagement is like so exciting, like who's not in love with love? So that's really, whatever engagement ring I'm working on is my favorite piece.
That's really nice that you get to work with like happy couples who are excited about this event.
It is really the best job in the world.
What is the most challenging part of your job?
The most challenging part of my job probably would be figuring out sometimes a particular style for a girl. Sometimes they come in and they have lots of pictures off of Pinterest and out of magazines and things they've taken online, and so trying to narrow those down and see what pattern that they have so you can find the perfect style for them and get their dream ring.
And you enjoy that part of it?
I love it.
That's awesome. So I have some more interesting questions
okay,
to ask you, just so that our readers can sort of get to know you.
Yeah, sure.
What is one skill that you have that maybe not many people know about?
You know, that is such a funny question because I think about this. I've been asked this before. My kids would probably tell things that are embarrassing and have. They gave me suggestions of things that would be good for that. For me, I really love to cook. So I really like to take just random ingredients and create something. And so that's like a lot of fun. I'm actually pretty good at it.
Awesome. So do you use a recipe as your base or do you just throw it together?
I throw it together.
That's fun. Do you ever make the same thing twice if it's really good?
I don't often make the same thing twice because it's just kind of whatever I randomly put together, but occasionally.
That's awesome. Okay, another interesting question.
Yeah.
If you had to eat one food every day for the rest of your life.
I totally know what the answer is for
this. What would it be?
Pastured eggs, free-range eggs. I love eggs in any form, so eggs.
Scrambled, hard-boiled,
fried eggs.
Everything.
Yeah.
Awesome. if you were on a deserted island and you had to pick 3 objects, what would they be?
That 3 objects I could have.
Yes, 3 objects you could have
with you. So the first one would be a book on shipbuilding. Some, you know, because I got to get off the island.
Great answer.
Second one would be a Breitling Swiss timepiece. It's their emergency watch. Yes, it is a dual frequency transmitter and a personal beacon locator, so I could
be found
and get off the island. Very cool. And third, probably matches.
That is a necessity on a deserted island for sure.
Yeah.
I love the answer about the watch. Is that something that like you came to know what it was through working at Brent L. Miller?
Absolutely.
Very cool. Okay, and what is your favorite part about yourself?
I would say I love people, and so I'm a hugger, and I think that's my favorite thing about myself, because I think if more people hugged, it'd be a much more loving, caring world.
Even when we met up today, you gave me a hug. That was very nice. Oh, sort of opened it up for comfortable a comfortable discussion. I loved that. Perfect. All right, thank you so much for coming today.